Hello and welcome back, everyone. Before we get to that fun part of the fire truck getting the mini off its back, we're gonna talk about the simulator again for self-driving. This simulator is called Carla, and you've seen a couple of basic things that you can do with it. Today we're gonna talk about positioning cars in the simulator, and we get at the end to that fun part of how we can make the fire truck trying to get Mini off its back. Very cool. Let's start. First thing we need to do, we import Carla and then run a very simple set of commands that look for fire truck blueprint, and it starts the fire truck. Now you can see it right there. What I wanted to talk about today is this transform object. Each car in the simulator has set transform and get transform, and those are the methods we're going to be using today. If we run it, we can see the structure of its output because we just print the this variable that we put into vehicle position variable. Transform is an object which is kind of unfortunately named. It's not really implying any transformation. It's more like a positioning of a car. It's made up of a couple of elements. Location, which is represented by X, Y, Z coordinates. And obviously it's a 3D space. It's not only X and Y horizontal. You can also be vertical. In this case, the car is firm, or the truck is firmly on the ground. The second element of transform is this rotation object. And the rotation is made up of the three elements. Effectively, it's just using all three axes in 3D. You can be rotated around those, any of those three axes, the pitch, the yaw, and the roll. And obviously, the axis of the pitch going this way across the car horizontally. The axis of the yaw is vertical, so if you turn the car across a vertical axis, it will be turning left or right. And then the roll is along this axis that goes alongside the truck. So if you roll the car, its right side or left side will be lower or higher. You know, you get the gist of it. Now, if we use a starting point or start point, which is the first of the possible spawn points in this very map. And if we print the start point, you can see that essentially it is identical to the transform that we get from the truck. So we've got X minus 64, Y 24, Z. Ooh, Z is actually different. Rotation is exactly the same, but what this says is the car, a car is normally on the ground at zero, whereas this initial starting point is about 60 centimeters off the ground. And I think this is done with possible camera. If you move to that spot, you start a spectator or a camera from there, you shouldn't be really the eye level should not be at the ground, so it would look weird, and that's why they're raising it a bit from the ground. That's all. Now, let's get the truck going, and we'll set the autopilot on, or set it to true. Off it goes. What we're going to do now is we're going to get another snapshot of where the car is, or where the truck is. And before we do that, let's just follow the truck a little bit before to make sure it gets somewhere. Because what I wanted to do next is to show you how we can do some navigation and plan a route between point A and point B. But before we go there, I would also like to point you to this object of the map in the simulator. By getting get map method of the world variable, we can essentially store it into a local town map. And then if you see, I ran a couple of type or, you know, print, it doesn't tell us much. So it just, the type is a map, color map. The if you print it, you get the name of the town. The way you could get something out of the map and start like referring to your road network of this map. One of those methods is to run this get topology method. And if I assign it to this roads variable and then print it, you can see that a lot of things here are referred to as waypoints. And that's waypoints are essential building block of the road network, because you can see it's in tuples here. So if we look at the very first element of a first tuple, we get waypoint is a wrapper to a transform, and transform, you know what it contains already, x, y, z, and rotation. The length of the road variable is, let me just run it. And I need to run all of this. The length of it is 200. So this entire road network is defined by 200 pairs of waypoints. I might be wrong here, you can see it in the documentation, but I think each of the pairs defines start and end of each lane or each of the element of this road network, because any point on these roads is represented by a waypoint, and you can navigate from one location to another by jumping from one to the other. All right, let's just see where our truck is. Anyway, it doesn't matter. What we do now is we want to get its latest location. And you can see it's different from our initial starting point. What we're going to do now is we want to grab this location represented by just X, Y, and Z. And then I wanted to show you how you can plot a route between two different points. So assume we want to plot a route between our starting point and where the truck was when I ran that snapshot. There is a couple of useful functions that come with the simulator. And for that, I'm importing this module that sits within this directory structure of Carla Simulator. And the way you do it is essentially adding this path to the system path variable. And it allows you to read that module from there or run this import command. Now, we go, and what we do is we've copied our new X, Y, and Zs. We just need to come here and paste it. All right. So there is a couple of functions that that module provides. So there is a global route planner for this town map that we now stored in the in this variable town map. And then there is a trace route function, and we want point A to point B, which is defined here by the locations. And then there is a function, utility function of Carla, to draw a symbol on the map in this very view. Let's run this. Okay, so now we should be able to go to our starting point where we initiated the truck, which is right here. And then you can see this is giving us the route to get to where we took another snapshot of the truck. Cool. So we when we were looking for the truck and couldn't see it, it was actually right here. And that is the route, and it's made up of waypoints, and it's essentially again a collection of waypoints like anything else when it comes to moving things and using navigation. In the future, this is the kind of thing that you will do in your self-driving endeavors where, you know, the very first question of in self-driving is like, where do you need to go? How do you get from point A to point B? You need to drive or orient the car towards your point B and getting there. Now, let's get to the fun part. First of all, we need to clear out all the tr- trucks and start a new one, because we need to to get the truck to a particular location, and the easiest way is to run our destruction script. Then we come back here and we run this little few lines of code, which should start the car at our normal starting point. What I wanted to show you here is how you then start using offset. Offset is where, in this case, we want to use the spectator window to a nice little vantage point where we can use the cool show that is about to unfold with the Mini dropping on top of the truck. And we define the spectator variable, which is what we get from the world variable. We get again spawn points. We didn't have to do it, it's already there, but we're using the very first starting point, which is like right there on the left. You will see it now, but we would like to automatically move this window with this line of code, and this is how we do it. We use transform, the usual. We refer to the start point and its location, but this is how we can do the offset on the location. We can run this plus and use color location object. And if we want to use to move away from the truck by 20 meters forward, 10 meters on the side, and then 4 meters up in the air, we would be facing the same way the truck was facing. So we also need to turn it around. And for that, we use the rotation element. The only problem with rotation, you can't use addition to with it. So the only way I could figure this out is to use color rotation, start a new one, and where the yaw is equaling the starting point yaw, but you then subtract 155 degrees. And then we run normal set transform. So you know how we get get transform and set transform. This is to actually set the spectator to that location. Okay, let's move there. Boom, this is what I was talking about. So we move 20 meters this way, 10 meters this way, and 4 meters up in the air. And now we're ready for the fun part, which is how do we drop the Mini on top of the fire truck? Very similar approach here. We first need to spawn or initiate the Mini somewhere else. Remember, we already found its blueprint right here. It sits right there. We spawn it somewhere else, and for that, we use the 11th element of the possible spawn points. We just need to make sure it's something different from where the truck is, because obviously there will be a conflict if you try to start it in the same location. And then we do this position calculation by taking very similar approach to what we did to spectator. The only difference we do is we want Mini to be at the back of the truck. We want to see if it tumbles down from it. And we also want to for Mini to be up in the air. And I just put 10 meters there. So it sort of drops on top of the truck because we're trying to make it serious, but also fun. Let's see some action here. But for the rotation part, I just left it as zero. I just left it for you as a placeholder so you can use it for other things. We could theoretically spin it around and make it face the other way, which is by subtracting 180 degrees here, but let's keep it this way. All right, here we go. Boom. The Mini drops on top of the truck. However, for some strange interpretation of physics in the simulator, the truck starts moving. Don't ask me why it didn't have the brakes on, but it's now moving. And as we can see, it's moving the faster and faster as we go. Okay, let's see this in action. So obviously this will hit this museum or whatever this is. And boom, this is like playing basketball with a Mini. How cool is that? And the truck's gone back. Hopefully this was fun for you. The main purpose was to show you how to use the transform object of the simulator and how to move the cars around between each other, how to show you how you do navigation. Thank you for your time, and I'll see you in another video very shortly.